My name is Hisahiro Yoshida, a research scientist at the Riken IMS Institute. We have been working on phenotype screening of groups of N-acetylnitrosourea-induced mutant mice to find allergic disease model. Among 3,000 mice examined, we have found an interesting line where the mice show continuous scratching. This movie shows the representative appearance and behavior of the mutant mouse. The first symptom was a spontaneous desquamation of the ear skin at around 8 weeks after birth, and within a few days, mice started to scratch their ears and face continuously. Phenotype penetrance was 100% in an autosomal recessive manner. This slide shows the appearance of mutant mice with skin lesions on their ears and face. Histopathological staining showed the thickened epidermis with inflammatory cell and mast cell accumulation in the dermis. The onset of dermatitis was from 8 to 12 weeks after birth. And interestingly, serum IgE and IgG1 elevation and serum histamine elevation were not detected until about 3 weeks after the dermatitis onset. From these results, we named this mutant stepwise progressive atopic dermatitis, or SPADE. After genetic mapping, we found a point mutation in the coding region of the JAK1 gene, which encodes a tyrosine kinase used in signaling through many cytokine receptors. An in vitro kinase assay suggested that this amino acid change caused the hyperactivation of JAK1. Therefore, we plan to suppress the dermatitis symptoms by treating the mice with a JAK inhibitor. As we predicted, painting a JAK inhibitor on the skin delayed the onset of dermatitis. We did experiments and found that the mutant JAK1 was affecting the skin, but not the bone marrow cells. This was surprising because JAK1 is a well-known signal transduction molecule for various cytokine receptors affecting immune cells. In addition, we found the genetic depletion of lymphocytes by crossing with RAG1 knockout mice could not prevent the dermatitis onset. So, some immunologists said that this mutant cannot be an atopic dermatitis disease model because it develops independently of acquired immune function. But many of the dermatologists encouraged us, saying that such a phenotype sounded similar to juvenile type atopic dermatitis development in human. In particular, the human patients usually have a defect in skin barrier function, and the disease starts with itchy dermatitis independent of serum IgE or serum histamine elevation. In fact, this mutant mouse does have a defect in skin barrier function, probably caused by serine protease overexpression due to JAK1 hyperactivation. To examine whether this skin barrier defect is the cause of the dermatitis onset, we painted petrolatum on the ear surface every 2 days starting at 4 weeks after birth. This prevented the disease development for more than a month. Transepidermal water loss rates of treated mutant mice were comparable to those of wild-type mice. Presymptomatic dermal inflammation was also suppressed. These results confirm that the skin barrier functional defect is the cause of dermatitis in the SPADE mutant mice. Here I summarize the dermatitis developmental steps in the SPADE mutant. In normal mice, the JAK1 STAT system regulates the constitutive appropriate levels of proteases in the epidermis, which will maintain the skin barrier homeostasis. But If JAK1 is hyperactivated, it induces the hyperactivation of the stats and proteases, resulting in skin barrier destruction, transepidermal water loss elevation, and innate immune activation, and that results in dermatitis onset. This disease can be prevented by petrolatum or JAK inhibitor. These results indicate that signal transduction via JAK1 plays important roles in skin barrier homeostasis, and this may be modified by environmental conditions. At present, we do not know whether genetic factors related to this JAK1 mutant mice are the cause of human skin inflammatory disease or not. But we hope this mutant mouse line will be a good model to investigate human atopic dermatitis, and we also continue to study it more closely from the pre-symptomatic stage to better understand the disease onset. Thank you for your attention.